So one of the comments of a listener was, where do you get information for your art of the unknown? Well, I get it through dreaming, and I get it through stalking on the land. But when I start actually working at drawing, I want my recapitulation to be part of the art. So I'm reviewing aspects of both my dreaming and my tonal life, and I am drawing in the best sense without reason. And that keeps it in the unknown, because I myself don't even know what the images are going to be, but I have the intention that they be beautiful, finely crafted as a tribute to my lineage of line workers. And then if I'm questioning what's going on, I go into more dreaming and leave the work for a while and dream what the images should be. In this particular case, I dreamed that the piece should be separated by the staff of Odin, this side the male side and this side the female side, and how to represent those things come free form as you leave your reason and trust your body to draw, because you've had years of experience drawing and becoming an artist. Let me show you the rest of my gallery here. These are large pieces, all with a taste of the intention of the unknown. Particularly when you get to what I call the light panels here, these are representations of plant forms and insect forms through a glittering matrix showing their energy field, and that is the purpose. The central figure of the shaman is behind a scrim, but it has his implements of power in his hand and the vortexes of energy in his body. This light panel shows the waves of energy as if stones are thrown in the atmosphere and causing ripples. So these are scientific and humble attempts to try to show the unknown, all of these. Here we have found bones in the landscape from walking, and trees that this one I grew and then carved. Again, elements of the known brought in to create energy of the unknown. Often drawing and ink work takes on a specific narrative that reflects the peoples of the land that I'm walking on and part of the Toltec lineage. So if I'm going to do a graphic depiction, it will resonate intently and intentionally with their style of a figurative line work. This here is the Amber Wall.
Oh, hold on. Hold on.
Where I ribbon, I'm
sorry. When you're on your one camera, you can't do, you know how awful it looks when you do that quick sweep. You got to make that graceful.
You don't have the drone or the Steadicam?
Or even a selfie stick.
All right, well, this here is the Amber Wall representing insects, webs. And again, this information I got out on the power spot on the land in my dreaming, and also when I opened my eyes, I saw that there were certain things going on in the land, like the spider web and things. And then I had to transfer that dreaming, stalking information to a
and
panel.
The opposite side of this just happens.
What would be the opposite of the earth magic? What would it be?
All this stuff that we were doing the shows in front of the first
few. Exactly. So this is out of the world while the Amber Wall side is in the world. One of the important features of this, besides showing the fabric of the universe and what I call the coat of armor, also shows the five chakras that are really important in the transmission of clear energy to the core of the body. Mm-hmm. At the top is a serpiente figure I have not placed the chakras in the Hindu system, the other two in the head area, because in the Tolteca system, the head area is influenced by flyers if you are activating. So you keep it pure, and your intention is to create a dream body, not another chakra point. These two canisters are based on sculptures I saw of Tolteca vaseware and an integral part of the work at this point. These panels are based on finding rocks when I'm walking in the land. I'm picking up rocks that have particular appeal to me, and I've always felt that I can't do better in my sculpting than nature does. So these represent fine, fine sculptures, one of a kind, that I place from the land. If you come around here, you'll see what I call earth. This light panel is the egg of conception, and come on in.
Oh, I've got it framed. We're in.
We're in? You can see as you move, again with this light panel, this is an organic way to create lighting effects. When you're channeling the unknown to bring in high tech to do something is a last resort. How can you begin with, let's say, candle and light, which is a traditional medium used by artists? How can you do light effects that are towards the organic method of depiction? As we go back here into the further part of the gallery, we encounter the tube, which is the other part of getting information. It's getting information with your energy body. The creation of this as a sculpture that could be used to get information on other worlds out of our known earth band. Please step in for a moment. So this is more than an installation. This is a projection booth where warriors form the ring of Quetzalcoatl and in complete darkness activate a flying disc. The walls open up to become horizon lines, and the whole group in mass flies and leaps into those worlds. The tube. Here we have works that also represent information from the unknown. This is the seeding of planet Earth by the Four Nawal Fathers, depicted here, one of them driving this seeding machine, represented by the Serpiente again. So we have the Tonal above ground with the pyramid architectures and the travelers, and then we have the insectic cocoons in the lower world. All of it being seeded into awareness long time ago by the Four Nawal Fathers. When you're channeling the unknown, you want to expand beyond just art and sculpture, so this becomes a whole tableau with writing table, altar, and we put our various objects, including clothes, here before we enter into the tube room.
Uh-huh.
Here's a body of warriors. This piece shows seven warriors, not a complete core without an eighth member. You as the viewer are the eighth member. And this is, for infinity flight, the shaman shapes. Shaman shapes have been used since the beginning of time on cave art throughout the American Southwest and all over the world to represent the complete flying energy body of the shaman. Because legs and arms are no longer necessary, what is a necessary component in creating worlds and collecting information are the eyes. So the eyes remain as also the vehicle for intending and willing places into existence when you're out in infinity. Depiction of a flying disc with warriors on it. In this case, eight warriors on a flying disc. And they are going to the sand world. And that's a hut on the sand world where people go to get replenished with orgone from throughout the universe, entities from all over the world, and there's a trough inside of these huts that are used. The red grid, which surrounds most of the earth, is depicted there, and then the framing of the magic. Every bit of work that an artist of the unknown does is to generate offerings that will last for eternity. The intention of the unknown is that these are sacred objects that other sorcerers in the future can get inspired and get real practical information from. So these are like teaching tools for other seekers.
Cool. And we will show you more art. Don't forget to ask us questions in the comments. And thanks for joining us.